Narendra Modi concluded his official visit to Bangladesh, and during this visit, the Prime Minister and his counterpart signed 5 key agreements aimed at bolstering ties between the neighboring nations. But before talking about the MOU signed, let us look at some of the key highlights of this crucial meeting. Indian Prime Minister Modi and Prime Minister Hasina jointly inaugurated several projects, one of which is the Mithali Express passenger train, which will operate from Dhaka in Bangladesh to New Jalpaiguri in India. The Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla said that the leaders emphasized on easing travel and connectivity between the two sides. Listen in.
Well, you know, there is already very active cooperation and collaboration between India, Nepal, Bhutan and Bangladesh under the BBIN, group. And of course, we are also facilitating, as you know, the exports of Bangladeshi exports of both these countries through India. We already have some established transit routes. There are proposals for other routes which we are examining. So this is an active area of ongoing discussion, and I think and ongoing cooperation, and it will only increase in time to come. There is great potential for sub-regional cooperation in different ways, and I think this is an area where we will see a fair amount of movement, even greater movement than what we already have.
The Indian and Bangladeshi Prime Ministers gave special importance to the healthcare sector. The two South Asian nations are currently battling the coronavirus pandemic, in the wake of which Prime Minister Modi gifted 1.2 million doses of COVID-19 vaccines as a symbolic gesture to Bangladesh. India also gifted 109 ambulances to its strong ally and neighbor. Teesta found a special mention during the bilateral talks. Foreign Secretary Shringla has said that the Prime Minister reiterated India's sincere commitment on talks and consultations with the involved stakeholders. Listen in.
The Teesta issue was discussed, and Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina did refer to the Teesta issue. Prime Minister Modi reiterated India's sincere and continued efforts to conclude this agreement in consultation with the relevant stakeholders. The Indian side also requested for early finalization of the draft of the interim agreement for sharing of river waters of the Feni River, pending with the Bangladesh side, which had been agreed by both sides in 2011.
Coming to the MOUs, Indian Foreign Secretary Harsh Shringla announced the 5 key pacts signed between the two nations. The pacts were aimed at disaster management, mitigation and resilience, establishment of framework of cooperation in trade remedial practices between India and Bangladesh, the supply of books, resources for Bangladesh and Bharat Digital Service, and employment and training center as well as the establishment of sports facilities at Bangladesh's Rajshahi College as well as nearby regions. The leaders also signed a pact between the National Cadet Corps of two nations. India has hailed Bangladesh for its role in sheltering Rohingya refugees. India's Foreign Secretary says that Bangladesh has done a lot to provide shelter and refuge to more than 1 million displaced persons from the Rakhine state. India has also provided 5 transits of humanitarian assistance to help Bangladesh in this regard. India's Foreign Secretary held a press conference in the backdrop of Prime Minister Modi's Bangladesh visit. Foreign Secretary Harshvardhan Shringla mentioned that Bangladesh's Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina lauded India's neighborhood first policy. Apart from supporting a transit route for exports and the Teesta River agreements, India will also provide assistance to Rohingya refugees sheltered in Bangladesh, which includes 5 transits of humanitarian assistance, infrastructure facilities for the Rohingya refugees adding to the existing 250 houses in Bhashanchar. Listen in.
Bangladesh had done a lot to provide shelter and refuge to over 1 million displaced persons from the Rakhine state in Myanmar, that in your endeavor, in your efforts, we have provided 5 tranches of humanitarian assistance. We will continue to work with you in order to elevate your, responsibilities in that regard. We have also worked in Myanmar under the Rakhine State Development Program to create infrastructure that would facilitate the safe, speedy and sustainable return of these displaced persons back to their homes. We have created 250 houses already in areas which already where they live. And I'm told that even among the 109 ambulances that you've just gifted, a few of them are earmarked for the camps in which these displaced persons are housed.
Foreign Secretary Shringla added that India has been helping both Myanmar and Bangladesh with forwarding the movement in repatriation of displaced migrants back to their homes in the Rakhine state. And India will continue to assist to facilitate refugees from Bangladesh to Myanmar in a constructive and sustainable manner.
There was also, a sense that India has been happy to facilitate any forward movement in the repatriation of displaced persons back to their homes in the Rakhine state. This is something that we have discussed with both Myanmar and Bangladesh. This is something that we have worked with both sides in trying to facilitate. We have always been happy to assist in a manner that is constructive, that secures the goal of, as I said, safe, speedy and sustainable return. And this is something we will continue to do in working with both sides. So this was certainly discussed, this was raised, discussed, and I think this is something that both our countries will continue to ascribe great importance to in the coming months.